In the port of Latakia, northern Syria, the dock workers stage a jamboree. They're celebrating the passing of a new law that takes all Syrian dock workers into the government-controlled Workers' Federation. From now on, they will get more pay, they will work only 8 hours a day, not 18, and they will no longer depend on the whims or corruption of the Taliban. The socialist state is in command. Tempers are short. In Syria, a celebration easily becomes a riot. But on this day, there was no violence. The crowd seemed genuinely happy. Life for them, they were convinced, was going to be better from now on. Just over 1 year ago, the left wing of an already socialist government seized power in Syria. After one of the bloodiest coup d'etats in Syria's turbulent recent history, the new Baath, or Renaissance Party, announced that it was the first government to genuinely represent the Syrian masses. The new leaders declared their faith. They were anti-West, pro-Russia. They pledged themselves to a policy of war with Israel, whatever the cost. For the first time in Syria, a revolution was conceived and carried out by the underprivileged, these men. The Syrian revolution has thrown up its own heroes. The peasants and workers can identify themselves with these men, men in shirt sleeves and workers' tunics, who actually look and talk like the people. Most opponents of the revolution, businessmen and landowners, fled Syria. Many were jailed and are still there. Syrians, however, insist that although unshakably anti-West, they are not communists, that their brand of revolutionary socialism is something new and quite different. No celebration would be complete without speeches, and Syrians are renowned for their oratory. The main speaker of the day is introduced, while the military, sole wielders of power before, stand by and watch from the sidelines.
I'm a little bit of 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 a little bit of